AI and its related technologies are evolving rapidly, attracting significant attention from interdisciplinary viewpoints in terms of application of such knowledges and technologies. This video will focus particularly on the use of AI technologies for 3D information. Specifically, this includes the generation of 3D information by AI, which is based on text and 2D image inputs, the display of 3D information using ChatGPT with Rhinoceros 3D, Grasshopper and Python, and 3D transformations using AI-based depth estimation technologies such as MiDas, ZoeDepth, Marigold. Also, you can see some AI experiments between reality and digital information such as NeRF and Augmented Reality. Text to image, image to depth, depth to 3D. Let's start with text to image to 3D process. Midjourney AI is utilized for the text to image process, and Rhinoceros along with Grasshopper is used for the image to 3D process. For image to 3D process, grayscale values determine depth map for 3D deformation. As in simple example, you can see this black and white radial gradient. White color part is getting higher as geometry. Another simple example is checkerboard pattern. You can see some differentiation with height and division of base surface, which defines smoothness of the input surface with control points. This is one of the experiment with Midjourney AI. Prompt is fish scale architecture. Grayscale image is made based on original image. Here you can see some 3D deformation with different heights. Light color part is getting higher, and dark color part is getting lower. In wireframe mode, you can see control points with different height on the grid. This is another Midjourney AI experiment with the same text input. Since this image is almost symmetry, it could be considered as a unit. It's like continuous facade skin with deformation. Surface deformation could be controlled with multiplication of height map values. As you can see, light color edge parts are popping out and having unique texture. Combination of units could be not only horizontally but also vertically developed. Next experiment is with this image. Text input is brain coral pattern. Again, grayscale image is made from the original image. First and second experiments were based on planar surface. For this experiment, base geometry is deformed globally. Base geometry could also be sphere or torus or other geometric primitives. You can have a look this output geometry with or without control points, with different display modes. This is top view of output geometry with color. Back to the idea with unit. With Grasshopper, which is a visual programming function in Rhinoceros 3D, UV division and height factor of the unit surface could be parameterized. Here, height map is again based on grayscale values. Also, in this example, unit itself could be set on different coordinate. Units could be applied on different global form. You can see this example of unit combination with movement. Here is an experiment of spherical transformation. In this case, depth parameter is on each normal vector of the sphere. Depth estimation with AI. Depth to 3D. Video to 3D. Until now, simple grayscale value was used for depth map. Here you can see some depth estimation technologies by AI such as MiDas, ZoeDepth and Marigold. This is a grayscale depth image in previous slides, and this is a depth map generated by AI depth estimation, MiDas. This is generated in demo space of MiDas on AI platform Hugging Face. Another depth estimation is ZoeDepth. Here you can see depth map output and 3D generation. Output format is GLB, which is used for AR, VR, games, and online apps. The other depth estimation is Marigold. Again, you can see depth map and 3D output. You can change image inputs as you want. This building facade image is generated with Midjourney. You can see generation of depth map and 3D from Marigold. AI depth estimation could also be useful for some sort of character design. This is Lion Dance experiment with ZoeDepth. Depth estimation is quite detailed as you can see here. With this method, extruded shape could be generated. This means it is suitable for making molds. Those are example of molds for baking quenille. Same as previous examples, image is generated with Midjourney and 3D is generated with depth estimation by ZoeDepth. Here is another mold example, fish cake. In this study, image is generated with Midjourney and this video is generated with image-to-video function in Runway ML. From each video frame, depth map is generated by ZoeDepth, and sequence of the depth maps could be combined as video depth. 3D output could be generated from each depth map, and it enables 3D scenes from multiple viewpoints. Another viewpoint. This is an overlay of 10 frames of 3D. Projection, plane, sphere, cone, cylinder, etc. To consider different type of base geometries for 3D conversion such as sphere, cone and cylinder, map projection is a good reference. Here you can see some map projection from a globe, with cylindrical, pseudo-cylindrical and conic etc. The Dimaction map is a projection of a world map, invented by Buckminster Fuller. Here is an unfolded surface of an icosahedron. Another reference is anamorphosis, which is a distorted projection. This is Holbein's The Ambassadors. You can see an anamorph skull in the foreground, which could be undistorted from the specific viewpoint. This is another anamorphosis reference, cylindrical anamorphic frog sculpture by John T. Hurwitz. You can see an undistorted frog on the cylinder. Andrea Pozzo's painted ceiling in the Church of St. Ignazio is an interesting example of trompe l'oeil, which is optical illusion of a real object or scene. This is Depo Boijman's Van Buningen by MVRDV in Rotterdam. The bowl-shaped building itself reflects the city of Rotterdam. Text to panorama. Panorama 360 to 3D. Skybox AI is an AI platform for text to 360 degree world by Blockade Labs. You can simply describe any scenes and set some graphic styles to generate 360 degrees worlds. This is an exploration of a spaceship environment. This is a panorama image output and depth map of the image. You can change different graphic styles as you want. 360 degrees scene could be unrolled as a 2D panorama image. What about the reverse process? Here is an example of a pseudo panorama of spaceship interior, which is generated by text prompt with Midjourney. Through a 360 degrees viewer, pseudo panorama image is converted as 360 degrees scene. Since the panorama image is not perfectly generated, 360 degrees scene is partly distorted in this example. This is another pseudo panorama image, also generated with Midjourney, an output scene through 360 degrees viewer. Together with depth estimation of ZoeDepth, not only 360 degrees scene, 3D model could be generated. This enables any position of viewpoints. 3D scan. LiDAR. NeRF. 3D scan technologies are rapidly developing. Here you can see some 3D scan experiments by LiDAR together with augmented reality. LiDAR is a ranging device which measures the distance to target objects. Since it's using a laser, there are some demerit points such as reflective objects or bad weather conditions such as fog or rain. There are 3D capture technologies with AI. NeRF, Neural Radiance Fields, is a neural network that can reconstruct complex three-dimensional scenes from a partial set of two-dimensional images. Here is a NeRF experiment with Luma AI at Zollhof Buildings by Frank O'Gary in Germany. After shooting multiple images, AI can reconstruct the 3D scene. One of the building facade is reflective, but it's well captured, while it is difficult to capture by LiDAR. As you can see, 3D mesh is not perfectly following the object form, since it's reconstructed by input images. This is another NeRF experiment with Luma AI's Flythroughs at Markthal Rotterdam by MVRDV. Drone-like walkthrough scene could be reconstructed smoothly. Text to 3D. Image to 3D. 3D output. Pointy by OpenAI is text to 3D AI. This is an example in demo space on Hugging Face. 3D point cloud is generated based on text input. Multiple 3D models are generated with the same text input. Here is another text to 3D AI, Shap-E by OpenAI. The 3D mesh could be generated with text input. It could be overlaid easily in reality using an AR viewer. The other example with SudoAI, here you can see the workflow of text to image to 3D to AR. You can describe any ideas and select an image which is generated by AI. Selected image is converted as a 3D model which could be placed in an AR environment. After exporting the GLB model, it is easy to use in external softwares or applications. ChatGPT. GH Python Grasshopper Rhino. GPT-4 image input. Rhino inside Revit Inkscape. AR. Here you can see a 3D exploration of trefoil knot using OpenAI's ChatGPT with Grasshopper Rhinoceros 3D. Let's ask ChatGPT, what is a trefoil? ChatGPT answers several different meanings of the term of trefoil. Let's ask ChatGPT to write a Python code to generate a trefoil curve in Grasshopper Rhino. ChatGPT answers with Python code. If necessary, you can regenerate response to get a better code and fix it partly on your own. Using GH Python component and pipe component, you can visualize a trefoil knot. Pipe radius could be changed with number slider. This is another ChatGPT GH Python example, Spirograph. As you can see, the Spirograph curve is changing based on four different input parameters: the radii of the two gears, the distance between the two gears, and the number of the points to generate the curve. These four parameters could be set as integer variables in Python code. The other example is Spiral. Again, based on different input parameters and transformations, you can see different output of spiral-like geometries. Back to the trefoil experiment, 3D Voronoi is generated based on the trefoil curve, and here is an example of trefoil curve as a camera path going through 3D Voronoi. Here is an example of trefoil sculpture placed in reality with an AR viewer. We can experience one-to-one scale 3D output at any place. This is an example of asking GPT-4 to write Python code using image inputs. After several conversations, GPT-4 can understand the input image quite well. Here is an output visualization using GH Python in Grasshopper Rhinoceros. As previous examples, input parameters could be changed. Using Rhino inside Revit and Grasshopper, the same GH Python code is functioning in Revit. Here, size of circles is converted into size of trees, and it could be visualized as realistic trees with Inkscape rendering in Revit. Thank you for listening. Please check out my other videos. See you again.